When Israeli commandos stormed this Turkish ship leading the flotilla, things quickly turned deadly. Demonstrators attacked the soldiers, who then defended themselves. 9 demonstrators died in the melee. Israel acted to keep weapons out of Hamas-controlled Gaza, but that didn't stop an international rush to judgment. The UN Security Council condemned Israel and called for an investigation. Sweden, Ireland, and other nations planned boycotts against the Jewish state. The incident also revealed Turkey as a major player in the Middle East, with Prime Minister Erdogan shifting his allegiance from Israel to Iran, Syria, and their axis of power.
Turkey was a friend of Israel for much of the last 6 decades. It's a democracy, it's a moderate Muslim country, it's a NATO ally, a friend of the United States, a tourist destination spot for tens of thousands of Israelis. And yet all of that is changing right now.
This represented a major realignment in the Middle East. Turkey, once a close ally of Israel and the West, now openly courting the likes of Iranian President Ahmadinejad, Syrian President al-Assad, and ultimately Russia's Vladimir Putin. So what does this shift of power and increasing isolation of Israel mean? Some in Israel and around the world believe it reflects biblical prophecy.
Given the fact that Ezekiel 36 and 37 have largely come true, the rebirth of Israel, Jews pouring into the Holy Land after centuries of exile, rebuilding the ancient ruins, isn't it remotely possible that Ezekiel 38 and 39, the war of Gog and Magog, couldn't that come true in our lifetime also, and possibly soon?
Following the flotilla incident, the Rabbinical Council of Judea and Samaria issued a statement saying the aftermath seem to place us at the beginning of the Gog and Magog process, where the world is against us, but which ends with the third and final redemption. Gog and Magog is a biblical reference found in chapters 38 and 39 of the book of Ezekiel, when a coalition of nations attacks the land of Israel. Whether or not this will happen soon, many believe war in the Middle East is looming.
As you watch the trajectory of events geopolitically here in the epicenter, events are lining up more and more in favor of Ezekiel 38 and 39 coming true, possibly sooner than most of us realize.
Hezbollah in Lebanon now has more than 50,000 rockets for a future conflict with Israel. Hamas continues to arm itself, and Iran's nuclear and missile programs stand poised to fulfill the mullah's dream of destroying the Jewish state. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.